Yes, the Russian ministry covered the meltdown that occurred in Leningrad. But what came next? Let's continue the subject from the last week's episode, the RBMK reactor history and design. After watching this video, make sure you will see the previous ones too, as they will give you a better context for understanding the subtle details. Details that were major reasons behind the Chernobyl disaster. RBMK Nuclear Reactor History, Part 2. Leningrad's accident was just the beginning. As we told you last time, before the Chernobyl disaster there was another major incident that included an RBMK reactor. Leningrad's power plant was the first to acquire the new reactor design, called RBMK, a few years before the Chernobyl nuclear power plant even started working. Leningrad's operators quickly realized that it will be a constant trouble. The reactor required regular maintenance, but nobody cared because creating it was a huge milestone in fulfilling the USSR's nuclear dream. But during one particular day, when the reactor was going back online, it started causing trouble. The overall quality and safety of this particular reactor design was one thing, but operators of any nuclear power plant around the world had an additional last-stand safety system, the scrum procedure. In the Leningrad power plant, as well as in Chernobyl, that procedure was started to prevent a catastrophe, including a meltdown of a reactor. If there was any problem that could not be resolved in any other way, and it posed a threat that exceeded the cost of the emergency shutdown of the reactor, the operator could use the AZ5 button. It initiated the procedure, which then should lead to the mentioned shutdown. A failsafe, we could call it. Restarting the reactor would be dangerous and costly, but it was nothing compared to a nuclear accident, including the worst any operator could think about, a meltdown. The Leningrad's Unit 1 caused such trouble, the operators decided that the scrum procedure is the only thing left to do. They pushed the AZ5 button and watched the readings on different machines and other equipment. Despite their confidence and trust in the procedure, the chain reaction inside the reactor didn't stop immediately. It got even worse. A partial meltdown occurred. The Ministry of Medium Machine Building, a place where covert operations and science met, which designed the RBMK, formed a commission to investigate the accident in Leningrad. Their report was, as often in the USSR, divided into two parts. One official, the other classified. The official statement of the committee said that the accident happened because of manufacturing defect. But the classified report clearly stated that there was an important flaw in the design itself. One of the processes inside the reactor called the steam void coefficient, was not running as expected. Suppressed information never reached operators working with other RBMK reactors, including those in Chernobyl nuclear power plant. You can watch the 8th episode from the Pripyat History miniseries on our channel to hear why was it even more important. So, you may ask, why the USSR officials wanted to cover their mistakes? The answer is not as simple as you may think. The design was an important achievement of the Soviet Union in a race between them and the United States. One could only imagine that acknowledging the mistake officially would certainly lead to the United States learning about this. This was not taken into consideration, not only because the USSR wanted to act as if their technology was superior, but also because the partial meltdown in Leningrad caused the release of radiation that covered a huge part of the Gulf of Finland. And, as you well know, the USSR could not be responsible for any international nuclear crisis, as one of the main characters of the Chernobyl miniseries by HBO said. The Soviets greatly celebrated creating the RBMK. It was proof of their power and knowledge. It was one of the biggest dreams they had. A clean, stable power supply in a country torn with many economical troubles. On top of that, RBMK was larger, about 20 times, and more powerful than any other nation's counterpart. One reactor could supply half of the population of Kiev with its outstanding output, 3200 megawatts of thermal energy, so 1000 megawatts of electricity. Soviets named the RBMK their national reactor, the gem of the USSR's nuclear technology. The largest and most powerful in the whole world, a statement for all those who undermined their superiority. It was not just a technological and economic breakthrough, it was political. When the Ministry of Medium Machine Building, known also as SREDMASH, ordered the plans, they knew there will be at least a few scientists, or groups of them, capable of that task. The most important one, in this part of the RBMK history, is Anatoly Alexandrov, who took the whole credit for the design. He was the director of the Kurchatov Institute of Atomic Energy, which you might know if you watched our episodes dedicated to Valery Legasov. The other design, which probably would be the second Soviet's choice, if the RBMK reactor wouldn't appear, was VVER. The plan wasn't picked because of both political and economic reasons. Firstly, the VVER's design was too similar to the Western ones. SREDMASH even called it the American reactor. This would be a political problem, as the Soviets wanted to create something on their own, not to be accused of poorly copying others' inventions. The second reason was economical. To base the design on the Western reactors meant that the USSR would have to acquire technological processes used in the West, and that was not possible at the time. One could say the RBMK won the contest because of these two reasons. A feeling of novelty, and its parts being able to be built in existing factories which didn't require any unavailable processes or specialized equipment. But this, as we all know, led to problems that as a result contributed to the worst nuclear disaster in human history, the Chernobyl event. Thank you for watching. I hope you had a great time and that you have learned a few new things. We will continue this subject in the next week too, so remember to check our channel next Sunday or Monday. Have a great day, guys. Take care, stay safe, and see you next week.